Welcome to Talk of the Town. We're glad that you're with us today because this is going to be a show that all of you are going to want to sit down and watch because it's about something that is huge for Henry County.
It impacts everyone in Henry County.
Humongous.
Yes. Exactly. Why don't you make the announcement?
We have with us today Dr. Randy Peters, who is the president of the Southern Crescent Technical College, and they are coming to our backyard.
Woo-hoo!
Actually, they're already here.
They're
going to make a presence in the sense of the development of a campus, long-term.
Right. Long-term campus.
Very cool stuff.
In the near future. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's just so many hours and hours of work was put into this, mm-hmm. and it's just so great to see it come to.
Yeah, fruition.
Yes.
It's a good word.
Fruition.
It's a good word. Yeah, and at Southern Crescent Technical College is our good friend, Kristen Miller.
Oh, yeah. Hey,
Kristen.
If she watches right now.
Hey.
And hey, Anna Taylor.
Who's Anna Taylor?
Anna Taylor also works at Southern Crescent Technical
College. Hey, Anna Taylor.
Yes.
How are you?
Yeah.
Now that I'm educated.
Great people.
All right, so Mother's Day happened.
It was great.
It was awesome.
Yes. I got a nice little gift or two.
What was it?
And some cards.
What was the gift?
Well, you know how the kids are.
She doesn't want to disclose.
They don't have a whole lot of money, so it really doesn't matter. It's the thought that counts.
Exactly. Yep. And garden party was awesome. So thanks for everybody out there. Thanks to Family
you
Medical Clinic.
You look so handsome, by the way.
You too.
Thank you.
Yeah,
handsome?
Great.
Thank
handsome.
You. Handsome. Whatever.
Purdy.
All right.
P-U-R-T-Y.
You're really going to want to watch this show because
awesome.
Somebody you know will be attending this school.
Exactly.
All right, stay tuned.
Welcome back. With us now is Dr. Randy Peters, who is the president of Southern Crescent Technical College. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me here.
And welcome to the county.
Big time. What a great announcement.
This is like big stuff. Tell us about it.
It is. I've only been here a few short months. I was the president of Heart of Georgia Technical College in Dublin, Georgia for almost 12 years. Came up here in October to find a project in full bore.
Right.
And now the legislature has passed a budget. We're just waiting on the governor's signature. That budget contains about $5.5 million for a new building to be built for Southern Crescent here in Henry County, on top of about another almost $3 million that has already been put aside. So $8 million project.
Wow.
We're very excited about that.
Yeah.
Of course, the Henry County School Board donated 25 acres of land next to Henry County High School a couple of years ago.
Right.
And
right. So that's the location.
It will go there. And the first of what is planned to be maybe as many as 8 or 9 buildings over the long distant future.
That's cool.
Well, you know, we had so many representatives hard at work, and the Chamber of Commerce were just pulling for this for years.
I have never been anywhere that has the community, the governmental, the private agency support that this facility for Southern Crescent in Henry County has. I don't know of any other college in the state that can claim the level of support that Henry County has provided.
Wow. What a compliment. What a compliment.
Let's step back. Let's talk about the funding, okay? And we're talking a little bit about it off camera, but you know, the appropriations is there. It's been approved.
That's correct. In the governor's proposed budget, the money was there. In the House version and the Senate version, it stayed.
Mm-hmm.
So when the conference committee put together the final budget, it's still there. We're just waiting for the governor to sign now. Once he signs the budget,
you can break ground.
Well, not yet.
It's
a revenue bond project, so they have to wait until they sell the revenue bonds. But once that has been done, then we could.
What would be that projected date?
Probably we're looking at maybe December timeframe.
Okay.
It's in design. We don't have the completed construction drawings yet, but it is being designed. It is being programmed now. Lloyd Ack and Sargent is our architect. They've been working with us diligently on the project, so we're very excited
about it. It takes
patience,
doesn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
It really does. It takes as much as maybe sometimes 4 or 5 years from concept to actual ribbon cutting on a building like this.
So. But the point is, I mean, we're not waiting for the facility to necessarily be built. I mean, you have a presence in the county already.
Well, that's right. We do. We do teach some classes at the Academy for Advanced Studies at Henry County High School.
Mm-hmm.
And I think we probably could add a lot more there already while we're waiting for the building to happen. But the county with the largest number of students that comes to our Spalding campus in Griffin is from Henry County.
Which Griffin's not that far away. So depending on which classes are offered in each one, and we'll get into curriculum later, I think it's important that we address that the Hope and the Hope Scholarship and the changes that it had. So if you're thinking of going to school right now, still a good time.
Well, that's right. There are a lot of people who think, well, the Hope Scholarship went away. They don't even know about the Hope Grant,
rumors,
which is a totally different subject, the Hope Grant and the Hope Scholarship. Basically, the legislature did about the only thing they could do. They went from paying 100% of tuition and books and fees to paying 90% of tuition, but not the books and fees. But what that will do long term is keep that Hope Scholarship and Hope Grant there for as long as we can foresee now. I told the students, we had an assembly at the college, and I said, well, 90% scholarship is way better than nothing.
Right.
I mean,
and
way
buy the used books,
so.
Right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, and used books.
Ones.
So, I mean, a student can go to Southern Crescent, and if they have to pay all their fees and all their books and the 10% left over from tuition, all those things, it's still probably less than $500 a semester.
Right. Well, they didn't do anything with the GPA. What do they have to maintain
GPA-wise?
Well,
now they did. First, I have to talk about the difference between a Hope Grant and a Hope Scholarship. Right. Everyone's familiar with the Hope Scholarship. In high school, you have to have a 3.0 GPA, you have to take certain courses, and you have to maintain the B average while you're in college to keep the scholarship. Well, we also have a program called the Hope Grant that when it was conceptualized, it was, well, there are a lot of people who don't get an associate's degree or a bachelor's degree in college. They need technical certificates of credit, or they need diplomas in something. And so the Hope Grant was put in place to mirror the Hope Scholarship, but for less than a degree program.
Ah.
Now, there was never a GPA requirement established for that. It was just stated they must be making adequate annual progress, which we basically tend to think of as a C average. Mm-hmm. Well, the legislature now has, in order to kind of reduce the funds being expended, have now put a B average on the Hope Grant also. But all that does is it make it just like the scholarship.
Right.
So the scholarship and the Hope Grant are now the same.
The same.
And, I think that's a good change. And people just need to be perhaps a little more diligent, work a little bit harder, ask for help maybe if they need it, get some tutoring, which we also provide. So, I think in the long term, the legislature has done us a real favor with Hope.
Good. Absolutely.
Let's step back and focus in on the history of the college. I mean, what is a technical college? And then you guys are emergence, really, of a couple schools, aren't you?
Well, that's right. Southern Crescent officially began the 1st of July this past year as a result of the merger of Flint River Technical College in Thomaston and Griffin Technical College in Griffin. Mm-hmm. And so the new combined college is called Southern Crescent Technical College.
Gosh, awesome. Love it. Okay. All right, mm-hmm. We're going to go to commercial break. And when we come back, we're going to learn a little bit more about Southern Crescent Technical College. We'll be right back.
Welcome back. We're still here with Randy Peters, who's the president of Southern Crescent Technical College. And Randy, in the first segment, we learned a little bit about Hope, some of the changes, some of the financial considerations.
Right.
Money's always an issue out there. What are some of the things that you're doing with respect to people that might come under some financial duress?
Well, as we said before, the biggest change is that Hope only pays 90% of tuition. It won't pay for books and won't pay for fees. That's going to potentially leave some people out. Even though we have about the lowest rates to go to college anywhere in the southern United States, uh-huh. Still some people may not be able to finance that. So for the first time ever, beginning very soon, we'll be processing student loans for Southern Crescent Tech students. Which ought to cover the difference. Now, we've always done Pell, which is a federal mm-hmm. aid program for lower income students, mm-hmm. And the Hope has been there for a long time. But you have a situation that a very low income student who has Hope and Pell has more money perhaps than a middle income student who has Hope but doesn't qualify for Pell. Mm-hmm. And so, I mean, there are lots of expenses besides paying tuition and books to go to college.
Yeah. How does this work? Mine are young and into the beginning years of high school and middle school, but how does this work? I mean, you say some student has money and one doesn't. I mean, do any of them have money, or is it coming from their parents and what their, is that how they qualify? Because what if the parent just says, I'm not gonna pay for it?
Every student fills out what we call a FAFSA, Free Application for Federal Financial Aid. And in that application, it talks about What your income, in fact, it requires of your IRS returns from last year.
From parents.
From parents, or if it's an independent student, from them. But it talks about their financial situation. Now, there is an expected family contribution towards a college education.
Okay.
And if you have already made that, well, then there's probably not a lot of federal financial aid left to do if you make more money than that. But if you're short, then there's things like Pell Grants, the student loans are Stafford's subsidized and unsubsidized loans. There are various things like that that a student can get help on. Now, we also have work-study programs, which is also a federal financial aid program. Mm-hmm. So if you're in that tier where you need money to go to school, there are a lot of ways to work that.
And you really
You have to do is you have to come to the school and you have to say, look, here's my situation. What can you do to help? And we've got a whole staff of financial aid experts whose only job is to help students figure out how to pay for college.
And if you do have to go the loan route, the interest is normally very low, and then you don't pay it until you graduate.
You don't pay it until there's about a six-month gap from the time you end going to school, whether you drop out or graduate. From the time you end school, about 6 months to pick up the repayment. It's one of the lowest interest rates ever on any kind of loan. And so a student who wants to go to school
can go.
The finances can be an issue, but it's not really an obstacle to keep people from going to school. Yeah. You can afford to go to college. It is worth the investment, but you sometimes have to figure out how to do it.
Right.
And you know, this FAFSA form, I mean, a lot of people get scared because of just like having to go in and fill out these documents that are just huge. We just did it for our daughter. And it's not a difficult process.
That's right.
It's not overly evasive in terms of you as individuals. Yes, it asks you for, you know, financial information. But also what's interesting is we just did some tours of some colleges. And overwhelmingly, the individuals that gave us the tours said, get out there and pursue the different financial opportunities, because invariably, not so many people do, because they perceive themselves of not being eligible.
So
that's
left
right.
So there's money there.
So there's money on the table. There are all sorts of scholarships, both because we're two previous colleges now combined. I actually have two college foundations, one at Flint River and one in Griffin. Mm-hmm. Both of them offer student scholarships for various students for various opportunities, different programs and all that. There are a lot of private individuals, foundations, corporations who provide money to go to school. We laugh sometimes, we're talking about financial aid. If you're a brown-haired, left-handed trombone player, somebody is offering a scholarship for that somewhere.
Absolutely.
Or you just have to look. Mm-hmm. And again, the financial aid folks at our college, or really at any college you may be interested in, the financial aid staff there can help you find that. They know those scholarships. They know how to get in contact
with those people. Go ahead.
Now, I was going back to the FAFSA form. Can you describe that a little bit more as to what it does? I mean, you're not just filling out an application for the sake of filling out an application. The way that I understand it, it almost intuitively looks for opportunities?
That's right. The FAFSA establishes the baseline of where you are financially. And then once that's established, then it becomes a springboard for where can we find finances for you to go to college. If your family income is too high, it says, okay, well, the Pell Grant, that sort of thing may not be what we need to look at. We may need to look at something else. But if your finances are in the lower income tier, well then, okay, there are some grants, there may be some student loans, there may be, you know, whatever is available. But again, you can't figure that out on your own. You need some help. The financial aid staff, that's all they do. They work with students to figure out how to pay for college.
Awesome. That's great. You know, we've talked so much about the college, and we could use three or four shows about it.
That's true.
When we come back, though, we're going to talk about the curriculum and know that it is time to go ahead and get signed up for that fall semester.
Right.
We'll be right back. Welcome back, and we're still with Dr. Randy Peters of Southern Crescent Technical College. We've talked about everything. You've given us a place to go to school.
Right.
We talked about finances, how to get to school. Now let's focus on the curriculum. What does Southern Crescent Technical College offer, curriculum-wise?
One of the things I am most proud about, Southern Crescent, and in fact the entire technical college system of Georgia, it's almost a joke. When someone says, what do you want to be when you grow up, we take that as a serious question.
Mm-hmm.
Whether it's from a kid or to a kid, to a high school student, to somebody in mid-career. Sometimes I still wonder what I want to be when I grow
up.
But we do take that occupational piece very seriously. People identify who they are with what they do. Mm-hmm. Unemployed people, one of the problems unemployed people have is, you know, I have no worth because I don't have work. Mm-hmm. Southern Crescent has over 100 different programs, ranging from the automotive, diesel engines, machine tool, welding, and those kinds of trade schools, or things that we kind of tend to think of as trade school, to a lot of allied health medical specialties like practical nursing, radiography, respiratory therapy, and those kinds of medical programs. Lots of business tech support kinds of stuff, computers, things like Cisco networking. We have the only forensic science program in the state of Georgia. Think CSI, but it's not just how do you take a fingerprint, it's why does that fingerprint stay there? Why is it that when we do these techniques, the forensic information is there? How does the chemistry and what's the science behind it? We have the only program like that in the state of Georgia. So there are lots of things, and if you're not going to go to the university, and you've already made that decision, you're not going to go into the military, then you ought to be in a technical college. Mm-hmm. I graduated from high school in 1968, and at that time, about 20% of all adult careers needed a four-year degree. About 10 or 15% required something more than high school. The rest of them, high school dropouts and high school diploma was all you needed. Today, that 20% four-year degree is still there. Almost everything else requires something beyond high school.
Oh, absolutely.
So people who drop out of high school, you know, they're in intensive care.
You right. You bring up a good point about the unemployment that's out there. You know, you're hearing stories in the papers and stuff about those individuals going back.
Where
to
did they fit
technical
into that
college
scenario
to enhance mm-hmm. their skills?
That's
Are you
right.
Seeing that.
And at the moment, I mean, we're slammed with students because of that. People in mid career, they've been laid off. All the way into their 60s and 70s,
yeah. Wow.
from a high school dropout who needs a GED all the way into senior adults.
Awesome.
But the point being, if you need to tune up your skills or you need a new skill set, the technical college is the fastest, least expensive way to do that.
Right. And day and night classes as well.
Day and night. I heard a statistic the other day that the unemployment rate in Georgia is about 10-11%. The unemployment rate for people who have some college is about 4.5%.
That's what
huge,
I was wondering.
Yeah.
Where
huge
does that
difference.
Fit in? Where does that fit in? Amazing.
It counts.
Thank you so much for
My
coming
pleasure.
On the show.
Thanks
for
having
taught
me.
Us so much. And remember, if you're in need of a college, your children, yourself, a friend, Southern Crescent is the way
That's
to go.
Right.
They have campuses right here in Henry County and a new campus to be built, I guess, breaking ground maybe 2012.
About that, right.
About that
right.
time. All right. Have a great week, everybody.
Bye. Thank you.